Guys, it's been 10 years. It's been 10 years. Oh my god, it's actually in front of me. Hello everybody, and welcome to the first episode of... Oh my god, I can't believe I can actually say it now. Final Fantasy 15. Alright, first things first. Let's make sure this is all good. Let's make sure all of the options are pretty good. Normal difficulty, that looks good to me. Active, that looks good. All of this stuff. Oh, Final Fantasy 15. It's right in front of me. And in front of everyone watching here too. I can't believe it. I have been waiting. I've been waiting, I've been waiting so long, and so many other people have been waiting so long. I've been waiting for this game for literally half my life, at the time of this recording. But now, I want to finally start this journey. I'm set, like, I've watched all of the stuff, I've watched all of the Brotherhood, Kingslave, all of, you know, the demos, I've played all the demos, I've looked up, you know, all of the information as it comes out. I'm ready for this. I'm ready for this adventure. And hopefully, I can share it with everyone watching right here, right now. I think this is going to be truly special for me and hopefully for everyone as well. So without further ado, let's go straight in. The tutorial offers interactive explanations about the story and combat. Final Fantasy 15, initiate the tutorial before starting the game. You know what? I think I'm good.
The decreed hour is come. Set forth with my blessing, Prince Noctis.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Take your leave and go in the grace of the gods.
Right.
Well, princes will be princes.
So much for royal protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a formal address.
Your Highness!
What now?
I fear I have left too much unsaid. You place a great burden on those who would bear with you.
You're one to talk.
I ask not that you guide my wayward son, merely that you remain at his side.
Indeed, Your Grace.
We'll see the prince to Alticia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said. Hate to break this up, but Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing. Do mind your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Your Majesty as well. Try to mind yours around our esteemed guests from Niflheim.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
You think I would?
I need only know that you are ready to leave home behind.
Don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road. Wheresoever you should go, the line of Lucis goes with you. Walk tall, my son.
I think we can forget about hitching our way there. Thought people were friendly outside the city.
You can only count so far on the kindness of strangers.
You're just gonna have to push her all the way.
I've already pushed myself to the brink of death.
Get up. Come on, car isn't gonna move itself.
Sheesh. I thought the car was supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
Push!
Oh my god, this is exactly the intro that I wanted. Oh, this is great. This is absolutely amazing. Come on, guys, it's not so bad.
Unbelievable.
Not exactly a fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
Look! These things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Prompto, don't even think about it.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nah, we just switched back there.
And it's my turn, Noct.
His turn.
My hands are killing me.
You'd rather I kill you with mine?
Easy there, tough guy.
Any luck?
Only a busy signal.
Hold the phone. Is it just me? Or was it supposed to be way closer?
I assure you, the map is correct.
The map said Hammerhead was right there.
Literally, next door.
Looks that way. On a map of the world.
Come on, guys. It's been 3 years. We just spent a little more, bit more time getting there.
The world's a big old place.
Filled with wonders.
Tell that to my legs.
Are you guys even pushing?
Hard as I can.
With everything I've got, we'll be there in no time.
Just as long as you stay, stand by.
What a start. Pushing our way towards the start of the game. Oh, it's great. Looks like we made it, though.
Hey there, y'all kept a girl waiting. Now, which one's the prince? Aha! Hello, Your Highness. Congrats on your wedding.
Not hitch just yet.
Lady Lunafreya's groom-to-be, here in Hammerhead.
Apologies for taking so long.
You best save your apologies for Pawpaw.
Well, that makes you...
Cindy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
Roll her in while I'm still young. Didn't your daddy tell you? She's a custom classic, not some beat-up old clunker. Prince Noctis.
Yeah.
Prince. Like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
What?
You got a long way to go, son. And that slackjaw's getting you nowhere fast. She's gonna take a while. Y'all get her in and run along.
Y'all heard him. Let's get moving. Right this way.
Now we play the waiting game.
Never liked that game.
Never any good at it either.
Well, the world is our oyster at this point. Yo, Cindy, got anything to tell us?
Y'all ain't never been out this way before, have you? Go on, have a look around. This'll make sure y'all don't get lost.
Very much appreciated. Visit the local tipster to gather information.
Well, might as well make good use of the extra time.
Now, this is actually the part where I fully admit that I've played the Judgment Disc demo, so this opening area I've got pretty much down to a T. But it's actually nice to be able to read everything in, you know, English, because everything was in Japanese in the Judgment Disc demo. So I very much appreciate that. I also have to remember that X is now confirmed, not circle. Alright, so if we talk to this guy right here, we can get some information on our map. Nearby havens have been marked on your map. Nearby parking spots have been marked on your map. New outposts have been marked on your map. A bunch of other crap has been marked on your map. Oh my god, so much marking on my map. Alright, we got zero Jill to work with, so we can't buy any of the food. But we do have some monster hunting quests. Restaurant proprietors will tip you off to hunts that award Jill and other prizes. Slay the local targets and report back to these tipsters to claim your bounty. Complete hunts and earn stars and increase your hunter rank. More challenging hunts will become available at higher ranks.
These nasties here have been a real pain in the rear.
Okay, looks like they added a bunch from the demo, so that's actually really cool. It was these two and Raindrops in the Night that were in the demo, but looks like Gorgeous in the Dust has been added. Well, I'm just going to take the first one right now. So we can keep that for later.
Stay alert.
But might as well check to see if there's any other different jobs available to us. Oh my god.
A moment, Noct. We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs. I suggest we confer with Cindy.
Broken down and flat broke.
Adding insult to injury.
Sounds like a pretty good idea to me. The Pauper and the Prince. Prince Noctis and his royal retinue set out and set sail for the neighboring land of Arcordo, where the prince is to wed his betrothed. Having channeled all of their funds into repairs for the regalia, however, the four friends must now find a way to earn some gild, a currency of choice outside Insomnia. Interesting.
For both after charging us that much.
Yeah, let's pay him a visit.
Alright, Cindy, we need some work. I got a hunting job, but I think that we should see what you've got to say.
She ain't gonna be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
Ask for a discount, ask for a loan, ask my friends. Can we get a discount of some kind?
Bit steep for a simple tune-up, don't you think?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson. Told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus around here. I'd be happy to pay y'all for your services if you're up to the challenge. How about it?
Sounds fair to me.
So much for finding an easy way out. Thanks a lot, Papa.
Earn 10 AP. Spend ability points to power up Noctis and his friends. Acquire new abilities on the Astral Sphere from the Ascension menu. Which is pretty much... Oh my god, it's in English. Oh, this is heaven. I can actually understand stuff now. Use the ability points AP to activate nodes on the Astral Sphere and acquire new abilities to aid you on your journey. Earn AP by leveling up and completing quests and strategic ops, or by impressing friends in conversation. Oh my god, I can actually read this in English. There was actually a translation, but I didn't use it much, so... Let's see what we got. We got combat. We got teamwork. We got stats. We got exploration. We got weight mode, which we'll probably not use so much. We got magic. We got recovery. And we got techniques. Right. This is very much... this reminds me a lot of the sphere grid from Final Fantasy X, and also the... I actually can't remember which one it was now, but mainly the sphere grid, especially with the way that these connect with each other. All right, let's see what we got. Reduce MP cost of phasing. Phase through an enemy's attack without using MP by pressing square at the last second, so that's a perfect guard. Use L and circle to take a step in midair after attacking. Interesting. Boost damage dealt when unscathed during chain attacks. And then with teamwork, we got boost link strike damage. Gain first strike against the enemy with a firearm. Arm adds to the tech bar. Automatically scan most enemies' weaknesses on the onset of battle. Deliver a powerful counterattack with a greatsword. Makes enemies flinch. Well, I'm thinking phase through... we don't have enough. We'll get the light phase. Let's get some good stuff on our defense to start with.
But don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds. Here, this ought to be enough for a place to stay. Just between us, though. Don't tell Papa.
Cindy, you are amazing. And let's equip that bronze bangle that we just got. And oh my god, I pressed the wrong button again. There we go. You have to use the touchpad to get to this menu, which is going to take some getting used to, but hey. It will all be gotten used to in due time. Equip Noctis and his friends with weapons, accessories, and outfits and techniques. Noctis can equip up to 4 weapons, while his friends can only equip 2. Right, okay, let's see what we got. So, an old bronze bangle, which increases my HP. I'm going to equip that to Noctis, because, you know, main character and all. Let's see, we got Tempest, we got Mark, and we got Piercer, which are all in the demo. Man, looks like we could get a bunch new different techniques. I can't wait for that. And we can level them up, and I can actually read what they say. I'm sorry, it's just... I played that demo so much, you just sort of learn what things do and things say. And obviously, playing other Japanese games, you just sort of had to get used to it. Earn jewel by completing hunts or by selling trinkets you find. Thank you for that little tidbit, game. And, oh, you get the little 16-bit Noctis and his friends. That's a nice detail. Alright, so 42. Oh, and it shows what I got equipped, the Engine Blade. A blade that Noctis received from Regis for his 16th birthday. It absorbs the elemental powers of defeated foes. Right, so... I might want to... keep that then. I do like the better attack, though. Okay, let's do this. Let's get one of these. One of these. One of these, and then another one of these.
Hey, come again.
And then what we'll do is we'll give everyone the new equipment. So Noctis, I got a second pair of those daggers because I like to put them on the down. And can I just use... Okay, yeah, I can use L1 and R1. We can give you the war sword, and I also forgot, I got the Masamune, which is a DLC weapon, which I might equip. There's no reason not to equip it. Should be pretty cool, I'll give it a go. Right, daggers. You get the Avengers, and you get the Kaisotus. Interesting name. And then you could do a bunch of stuff, like change their outfits, change them to like casual outfits and stuff, and no jacket, but we'll keep them in the regular getup for now. It actually changes some stats as well, which is actually kind of cool. Anyway, onward into the world set out before us.
Keep it moving.
Yep.
I actually do appreciate that they just get us straight into the action. There's no, like, starting in a town and having to, like, you know, do some stupid town stuff, even though it's not usually stupid. You know what I say? When I say stupid town stuff, I mean actual, you know, like, tutorial stuff. The threat meter displays when an enemy detects your presence. I know all this stuff, let's go into combat, but might as well go through it. Hold weapons to, conjure weapons to attack. Hold the circle button to blitz the enemy with consecutive attacks. Change weapons on the fly and adapt to the flow of combat. So, swap weapons with the D-pad, hold circle to blitz. So you can do some cool stuff like go into this, and then if you hold different directions, you actually do different attacks. I'm gonna do a bunch of stuff that it's not gonna teach us yet because I'm a super cool guy, but... Oh, jeez. Looks like... they can still use techniques that I'm not supposed to use yet, so I can appreciate that.
Far less trouble than anticipated.
Come on, I got a date with a cup of noodles.
Not bad.
Excellent work. On we go.
What we got here?
What happened here?
A telegraph pole's been split in two. And not just this one either.
The hell do you think did this?
Hard to say. Natural disaster, perhaps?
You sure? The hammerhead doesn't have a scratch on it.
Maybe a huge monster came and knocked him down.
It better not be the varmint Cindy was talking about.
I don't know, Gladio. Knowing our luck so far, I bet money that it is. Man, this is a pretty looking game. I'm really impressed that they got the engine running this well, the Crystal Tools engine, because the first few demos, oof, they were a little rough, but now it is pretty stable, I've got to say.
They aren't gonna know what hit them. Let's do this.
Okay, we got a point warp over there. I'm pretty sure this is gonna teach us defense. Press square to roll dodge and evade enemy enemy attacks. Hold square to defend against oncoming attacks. Defend against free attacks. All right. Give me your best shot, Scorpions. Reaper Scorpions. There we go. And then we could go in for a parry. And then if we're lucky, we can get some links with our party. Alright, team. X-Slash! Man, that's super cool! God, combat looks so stylish. I absolutely love it.
Whose side are you on?
Didn't mean to do that.
Ah, sorry, Ignis. You know how it goes. Alright. Onward to the next objective. God, this is a pretty expansive world. God, when you look at the map, and they're about to talk about something, but if you actually look at the map and you look at how far we've come from Hammerhead, it doesn't actually look like we came that far away, but when you actually look at it on the world map, anyway? It's actually pretty damn far. And then when you zoom out the world map, which I'll do after this conversation is over, just to make sure I don't break it up too much. But when you zoom out on the world map, it's pretty freaking huge. So like if we go over here and, oh wow, it's actually filled in now. They actually didn't do that for the demo. Oh, I can see, oh damn, that must be where the meteor crashed and, okay, sorry, getting excited. Okay, getting really excited right now. All right, let's take care of these last few Reaper tails.
Give it your all.
Pretty sure this is where it teaches us about warping, so let's just go in. Yep, R1 to lock on. Triangle to warp strike. Noctis can instantly warp strike a targeted enemy at a cost for a cost of MP. The farther Noctis blade warps, the more damage his attack deals. Sounds fair to me. And did I get the success? Wow, already. Ow. Alright, damn Reaper Tails, let's take you out. But we'll take you out in style. Because styling is winning. God, it just feels so much better. So much more responsive. Which is really good, because I was mentioning about the engines before, but that engine was having problems from what we can gather. So the fact that they were able to get it running so well really impresses me.
You're on fire today.
What can I say?
Nice. Mission complete.
Who could this be? Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
That's great, because I got one more hunt for y'all. Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off, and we ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out a spot in an old shack nearby.
Old shack? Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
Well, it's the only lead we got so far.
Needs us to find some Dave guy.
He went missing?
Not missing. Said he's holed up in that shack.
So, one little trick I actually know about the stamina bar, and let's see if I still got it. If you press circle just before the stamina is about to go, it actually refills your stamina bar completely, which is the main reason I like to keep it on. There is actually a visual indicator in Noctis' animation for when to press circle, but it's a little bit harder to see.
What's this?
Let's check this out. Mutant Dullhorn sighting. Codename, Bloodhorn. Characteristics, red tusks, extremely violent. Outstanding bounty on saber tusks in the area. Well, there are the saber tusks.
You okay?
We are now.
Spoke too soon.
Thanks, Brompto. Oh, jeez. Not gonna take me out. Now, apparently, they've improved camera in close spaces, which actually looks like to be the case, because I remember a bit before that they were having a bit of trouble in close areas combat. Ah, oh, jeez. It was actually a bit of a quick time event there, but they actually knocked it off before I had to do the quick time, which is actually kind of great. Okay, let's go out and then back in.
Hey, what about the shack over there?
Damn it, Prompto, doing the victory music. Oh, it's so good. From what I can gather, there was actually a lot of time and thought put into this game, and from what I've seen so far, I obviously can't fully judge it because I haven't, you know, played the full game yet, but it seems to be the case, which I'm really excited for. Alright, looks like we've got a second old shack over here. Let's see if we can find this Dave. The most Japanese name ever. Dave.
Not yet. I've got a plan.
So we got a bunch of saber tusks. Walk to the windmill, huh? Friends propose strategies to gain an advantage in combat. Follow their strategies to earn AP. Blue markers indicate points you can warp to instantaneously. Locate the blue marker on the windmill and point warp to it.
What are we looking at?
Alley-oop! Noctis will quickly recover HP and MP while hanging from high ground. Warp strike a distant enemy from the position to receive a damage boost.
This creature is known as a saber tusk.
So this will be pretty cool.
Extracting game from the safety and comfort of burrows.
That's a bit heartless.
You know what, Ignis? I like the planet Earth description you gave, but do you have to do it in the middle of battle?
My pleasure.
Damn, this Masamune is tough. It is a DLC weapon, so maybe I should have expected that. Thankfully, it doesn't seem too overpowered, so I don't feel too bad about using it. Oh god! Thanks, Gladio.
Whose side are you on?
Sorry!
Oh yeah!
Hey, who's out there? Look who's in here. The man of the hour. Dave, right?
Been looking for you.
Didn't mean to cause y'all any trouble. I've been stuck here on account of my sprained ankle. Yeah, something funny about them varmints. I gave them hell, but couldn't finish the job. Still one mean mutt about. Well, y'all don't look much like hunters, but what do you say? Put that puppy to rest for me?
You know what, Dave? Considering your condition, we'll do it for free.
Oh, yeah. We'll take care of it.
Y'all got guts, that's for sure. Let me tell you where I last saw him.
Got a magic flask.
Way to show some spunk. Now let's get ready to kick some tail.
Earn 30 experience. Oh, take it. Okay. 0.22 miles that direction, huh? Doesn't seem too bad. We could pretty much do that on foot. Yo, Ignis, what's up?
It would be wise to rest up before we set out.
You know what? Considering the fact that we have a bunch of experience, a formidable foe awaits. Prepare for this encounter by resting at the nearby haven. Ignis will cook a status-boosting meal for the party. You know what? Sounds like a good idea.
In that case, let's find a spot to make camp.
The hunters are really out in full force around here, huh?
So they're the new Crown's Guard or something?
Similar, though technically a civilian outfit.
They've definitely seen a lot more action than we have.
Is it cool that we rock Crown's Guard outfits?
Be worse not to. They made them especially for us.
Even got a sweet insignia on them.
In the Crown's Guard, your attire identifies you, so wear it with pride.
Man, a little bit of lore building there. Let's absorb some of our magic. Elemency, fire, ice, and lightning magic requires elemental energy to cast. Absorb energy from deposits found near havens and other places around Eos. So, for people who don't know how the magic works in this game, it's got a little bit of Final Fantasy VIII's draw system, but also a bit of crafting to it. Now, at the first sound of that, some people might be put off by it, because I know the draw system in Final Fantasy VIII had people very split, but considering how much I've messed around in the Japanese version just using random items, this system's actually really fun, so I'm gonna have fun making some electrifying concoctions, if I do say so myself. But anyway, enough of that. We're here. Set up camp and take a little bit of a rest. Camp at Havens to enjoy a status-boosting meal and a good rest to tally up EXP. Let's do it.
Call it a day.
All right. I'ma pitch the tent.
Mirio Haven. 0 days elapsed. Report card, A+. C for my finesse, but A+ for my offense. Just a couple of guys camping out underneath the stars. Now there's actually a bunch of stuff that we can do during the camping, which I'm looking forward to, and there's a few things that I want to do in terms of this LP, which I think can be a little bit of fun. But I'll get to that once they appear. I want this to feel like an adventure. I want this to feel like a road trip, so there are a few things I'm still mulling over in terms of how to handle some stuff, but I got a pretty good idea. Ignis uses ingredients to prepare meals at camp, acquire new recipes to expand Ignis's cookbook, and a variety of bonuses available. Right, so we can increase our attack by 10, increase the maximum HP by 50, increase attack by 30, increase maximum HP by 150, and increase our attack by 20, or increase attack by 100, enable sprinting without expending stamina, and prevents poison. Let's have a croquet madame. I probably completely butchered that language, but you know what? I don't care. It looks good, it probably tastes good, that's all you need to know. Now please enjoy this extremely high definition food, which will no doubt make you hungry. I do love that they kept the fanfare till the end. It's time to tally up all of our EXP. So we reached level 2. We might actually reach level 3. Yeah, looks like it. Nice. Looks like they did a little bit of balancing. Oh, and we have 40 AP to work with. Should probably do that. Prompto's photography went up, Ignis's cooking went up, Gladios's survival went up, and Noctis hasn't done any fishing yet. So everyone has their set skills which they can use, and you can level them up throughout the game. I don't know what like the maximum are for each level. In the demo it was level 3, but I imagine they could go much higher than that. Prompto is documenting the journey in photographs, review the pictures he takes, and save his best snapshots. So, in terms of progression, in this game, I want to save as many of these photos as possible and make an album. Looks like we can have 150 photos, which is quite a lot to be fair. So I want to pick at least one from each of these and have them in a nice little scrapbook for the end. So I think that'll be a nice thing to do. Obviously, we won't pick any that don't stand out in any way.
So unfair.
But I think it's only fair that for the first one, we pick this one right here. The start of our journey. And hopefully, many more journeys to come. I still can't believe it. I actually... I can't believe I've never waited for something so long and have it actually pay off. That's probably the part that really surprises me, because there have been games that people have waited for, and I haven't waited for them personally, but they just never seem to live up to the expectation. And there's still that people are still waiting for, and they probably won't live up to expectation. You know, stuff like Half-Life 3. That's the big one that comes to mind. And ones that come out, like Duke Nukem Forever and Aliens Colonial Marines. But the fact that this is the one I've been waiting for. This along with The Last Guardian, and they both seem to be reaching my expectations. Man, it just feels so good. It just feels so good. And the fact that I actually get to play the full game, and I feel ready for it, like... Sometimes I mentioned it a little bit before, but, you know, with all of the universe stuff, I think I'm completely ready to tackle this game in its entirety. I think I know the characters enough with their backstories. I think I've got a handle on the combat, so I don't have to worry about practicing that too much, but... Man, I'm just so looking forward to this, you have no idea. Okay, but gotta calm down. Gotta take on the boss. They're probably talking about the boss. I should probably focus. You look like a mean beastie.
What? Scared, big guy?
You ought to be too. Thing's vicious.
You sure? Looks tame to me.
Yeah.
Look out!
Yeah!
Show those boss!
Nice one.
It's not over yet.
Let's take this guy down. Your friends can perform special techniques to aid you in combat. I could have used these before, but I was saving them for now.
Prompto, you're up.
Wouldn't expect.
Start us off, Prompto.
Good.
Combo time! Nice. Damn, that does a bunch of damage. Ignis, mark him. Ignis's mark is pretty good for single targets, but I think it's personally a lot better for multiple. Alright, Gladio, see if you can knock him with your Tempest. Damn! At least we took them all down. Nope! No dice. Let's warp over here. And then warp back to him!
None the worse for wear.
Bring on the next one.
Huh. Nice job, team.
Hello?
Hey, Dave just called and said he's safe. Thanks for finding him.
Ken.
Nice work, y'all. By the way, the old girl's looking good as new. Oh, while I got ya, if y'all want to fix her up before you roll out, let me know.
Huh, interesting. Sure. I'll take it.
Sounds good.
She'll be waiting at the garage.
Gotcha.
Man, we got our car back. We did it all within the first episode.
Who's up next behind the wheel?
Ignition. Things are looking pretty good. Alright, let's take a look at our map and see where we need to go. It's a little bit of a ways, but I'm pretty sure I can fill in the time. If not, I can just cut right here.
I couldn't even keep one.
Not sure I'd do anything.
Man, I want this to be a pretty laid-back LP as well. I want to enjoy the ride. I don't want to feel super obligated to show absolutely everything. I want to show a lot of stuff. I don't know. It's kind of weird trying to explain it now that I actually think about it, because I want to enjoy this, I want everyone else to enjoy this, and as I was saying before, I want this to be a journey. I want us to go out, explore, do everything that we can, show everything that we can, and just enjoy this, because considering how long everyone's been waiting for it, I think we all deserve it. And you know what? That's the last time I'm going to mention that, because I've mentioned that a few times now.
It's rude to keep a girl waiting. You better apologize. What is that?
That's a threatening beastie.
A live hurricane. That thing's like half bird, half storm, half airship.
You realize that's three halves.
Would explain its size.
Awesome in every sense.
Man, the creatures in this world can get pretty crazy. Some more crazy than others, but we'll get to those when we get to those. Let's just continue forward on the road ahead. And accidentally run out of stamina, because I mistimed that button press. Oh yeah. Whoops! Well, we haven't seen this area yet. Looks like it's pretty much just mostly desert, but it's a pretty looking desert, so I can give them a pass. But as I said before, I've done my fair share of exploring around here, and we definitely will take episodes to focus mainly on exploring, but for now, I just want us to get back and get our car, and then I think that'll be a good place to stop. Nice little introduction, nice and laid back.
So far, man can walk.
Our Crown City upbringing didn't prepare us for this.
Pretend you're walking to the car.
Let's just head on back to the pit stop and get our car back. Elliop. Oh, there she is, the beautiful girl. Goal? I meant to say girl. I don't know where goal came from. I meant to say the beautiful girl. Man, that looks great.
Sorry about the wait. Ain't she pretty?
She's almost too pretty for the road.
She's back! We should all get a picture with her.
All the more reason to ride with care. Oh, and before I forget, would y'all mind making a little delivery for me?
Delivery? Sure. I don't mind.
No, not at all.
Perfect. Thought you'd say yes. So I already put it in the trunk. There should be a motel on your way to Galden. If y'all wouldn't mind giving that to the owner, that'd be swell.
Grandpa like grandkid.
Now that she's all polished up and ready for the road, would you care to take her for a little test drive, Noct?
You know what, Ignis? I think I'll take you up on that offer.
Sure, why not?
And I needn't remind you to exercise caution.
Oh, when have I ever been known to be not cautious? But you know what? I'm pretty sure that this is a good point to end it. So, next time on Final Fantasy 15, oh my god, it feels so good to say that, we'll be going in the Regalia and heading off to our next destination. See you guys then. This is going to be one wild adventure.